I'm Raj Dave at C3 2018 in Orlando, Florida, and I'm very privileged to have a distinguished guest with me, Dr. Tejas Patel, who is a chief interventional cardiologist and a chairman of Apex Heart Institute in Ahmedabad, India. His name is world known for his work on transradial intervention and many complex intervention techniques. This meeting was privileged today to also inaugurate a new book written by him called Plan B, Complications. It is a fantastic atlas, and I think that our viewers will have a great time reading this new book. But what I want to talk to Tejas about today is really the revolution of transradial intervention. Today we had the opportunity to hear your great talk on transradial intervention twice. So tell us about the history of your journey in transradial intervention and how you got to become a transradial interventionalist.
First of all, Raj, I am honored and privileged to be here, to be invited over here. Transradial was actually my dream. I used to dream transradial procedures way back in 94, 95, when I was very young. And I read Kimney's paper and I wanted to be into it. But at that point of time in India, for a short while, transradial was introduced and it was ridiculed just on the basis of Indian arteries, Indian radials being very small and Indian people being very short statured. But Dr. Saito, my mentor and my very dear friend, when I saw him doing radials left, right and center in Japanese population in his lab, who were even smaller and more petite than Indian population, I was convinced that I must introduce this beautiful procedure in my country. And with his help, we started, and God forbid, it has become a very stable teaching program and a very rewarding venture for me.
Yeah, absolutely. So Dr. Saito is very well known to our meeting. He received the Lifetime Career Achievement Award here 3 years ago. He also came here and discussed several techniques related to transradial intervention. Let's talk about complex PCI and transradial procedures. Because I think one of the things that exists in some of the physicians' mind is that, you know, when we are dealing with complexity, it is not so easy to do it from transradial. So I'm sure that there are certain cases that you may say, you know, we may have to go femorally. And the transradial might not be a most optimal route. Or do you do majority of your cases transradially, and how complex is complex for you?
It's a good question, Raj. If you would have asked me this question before 15 years, my answer would have been different. But now almost 99.9% of the procedures in my lab are transradial. And we have learned everything hard way. You know, we face the problems, we try to troubleshoot the problem, we try to find the best possible and the simplest solution, and that is how. It was a teamwork between me, Sanjay, and my colleagues, even my techs and nurses. They also used to give us, you know, their views, and we were open to take their views. And that is how we developed different techniques to reach from puncture site to the coronary ostium. And once you know that, once you cannulate the ostium well and coaxially, the procedure, whether it is transradial or transfemoral, it remains the same. So we have learnt it hard way. And nowadays, practically every single thing we are doing transradial, of course, we don't make it as a prestige issue, but we are comfortable doing it.
Now, I think this is a key point, that we don't need to make this an issue of a physician ego. You know, it is a great technique, you know, allows early ambulation, you know, reduces bleeding complications, and it certainly is very feasible in 99% of the cases, just like you have suggested. So let's talk about some nuances of radial artery preservation, because that appears to be an important issue, and especially in the United States, where we have medical legal issues, that can be an important thing. So give us some pearls of wisdom about what do you do personally in your lab for radial artery preservation?
Yeah, it's a good question. You know, the personality, Dr. Samir Pancholi. He has done pioneering work in radial artery occlusion, and we have been part of that work, you know, our group also. And at that point of time, when we started Transradial, the radial artery occlusion rate was somewhere in the tune of 10% or even more. And we have been able to bring it down to less than 2% now with patent hemostasis technique. And after PROFIT 2, which we published, you know, ulnar compression while giving a patent hemostasis, it has been brought down to less than 1% now. So practically that problem has been taken care of by and large. We can also predict, you know, the radial arteries which are going to occlude. So sometimes we avoid, like octogenarian, diabetic, small statured female, you know, with a feeble pulse. These are the radial arteries which don't do well as far as the patency is concerned. So all these things we keep in mind. But patent hemostasis has been a real blessing to the interventionalist to reduce, you know, the radial artery occlusion rate to their patient. And you can do 1, 2, 3, 4 times, you can use the same radial. And I personally pass on complete credit to Samir Pancholi for the same, for this very ingenious work.
Yeah. Now, in your lab, in US, there's a lot of use of radial bends of different types. You know, every company makes one now. But you do mainly manual compression in your hospital, correct?
Manual compression for the diagnostics, because it is not cost effective for Indian population. But
right.
But all interventions we use
radial
band. Yes.
I see. Okay. How about bifurcation and CTO patients? Are you doing them radially also?
Yes, the most complex of the bifurcation CTOs we are doing through radial, because the techniques which we developed, that is combo technique and balloon assisted tracking, we have been able to push 7 French guide catheter and cannulate coronaries without much problem.
So the idea is to put in a small amount of 7 French sheath in the radial artery, introduce the guide with the balloon inflated at the end of the guide, and just advance it to the
corner. Yeah, that's right. Or else you can use 125 centimeter long, 5 French multipurpose diagnostic catheter, and you telescope it with the guide catheter, and you can push it, no problem. Yes.
Great. So I think that these are some important words of wisdom, and we also we'll have a book signing ceremony for Dr. Patel's new book, Plan B, Complications, which is published by HMP Communications. So I look forward to seeing you at the book ceremony. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Raj. Thanks for everything.
Very welcome.
Thank you.